Good morning, everyone. I started this company 4 years back, and last year what happened is I was given the privilege to meet at least 100 HR heads, CIOs, and CEOs, and I was also given the privilege to help them launch an artificially intelligent bot that regularly talks to employees, and then, on the basis of those interactions, tells them who is unhappy, who is most likely to leave, and the exact reasons why. But all of them had one single question. Every single one of them had one single question, which even I struggled with in my initial days. And that question was, why should we trust artificial intelligence? Why would our employees confide in and open their heart out to an artificially intelligent chatbot? And that got me boggled. So today what I'd like to do is share a story. A story that's very, very personal. A story that can show you that AI is not coming soon. AI is already here. Right? So what happened is, there was this 1,000-employee company, 1,000-plus employees, where the CEO suddenly gets this email that 10 employees are unhappy and most likely to leave out of the 1,000-plus employees that he already has. So like all of us, he questioned the authenticity of the AI and was wondering that, is this really accurate enough? So he put his leadership to a task to judge the accuracy of the AI, and they came up with an idea that what if in your next coffee with CEO session, you invite these folks who were surfaced as high risk. So usually what happens is 20 employees are surfaced in these coffee with CEO sessions, but this time he said, let me invite two people who will surface by the AI. So when these two people were invited to the Coffee with CEO session, interestingly, none of them said anything negative or constructive. And the leadership was really hoping that at least these two people would speak up. So again, the leadership went back to the drawing board and came up with another idea. That what if we do a one-on-one? A one-on-one where the CEO personally sits down with one of these ladies who was surfaced, and sits down with them in the coffee, and he used this one line where he said that, I'm just like your elder brother. I'm just like a friend. You can share this with me. I know you're going through something, and I can promise you that I'll keep it confidential. And what happened was just beyond me. What happened was, I've been told this lady broke down on the spot. And the reason that she stated was the fact that her manager had been harassing her. And that's when I understood that harassment comes in so many forms. Even negligence is a form of harassment, right? And this is where, you know, while I was really happy that AI could really help a human being here, I was also amused that can AI really make a human being cry, a lady cry? And this is just not it. There were so many more stories where people surfaced issues around discrimination, racism, minority religion issues, all kinds of issues coming up through the AI. And the common theme here was that all of these topics are very, very difficult to talk about to human beings, especially strangers. So the key question remains, why is it that all of these employees chose to open up to artificially intelligent bots and not human beings? And the answer was so simple. A, they have empathy. The AI bots can respond with empathy. They have patience. They will not judge you. They do not have a bias. And the interesting bit was, it doesn't happen immediately. The same way you meet a stranger for the first time, you don't open up immediately. So the first interactions with the AI bots, the employees did not open up immediately. But the beauty was that the AI bot constantly kept building a context over a period of time. So the bot literally knew who this lady was, and which is why she chose to open up. And I think this is where the irony and the most disturbing fact here is that nowadays, the HR or human beings lack these values of approachability, sensitivity, empathy. And the disturbing fact here is that even if you replace the person sitting behind the laptop, you're chatting with someone, even if you replace the AI bot with a human being, the fact is that you won't even notice. And that's saying something, right? So this is where, you know, we even deep dived into ourselves to figure out why. Why is it that the CEO as well should trust the AI here? The CEO came with some interesting lines where he said that predicting human behavior and people behavior and human emotion is something which is very, very hard to do. Can we leave that to human judgment? Maybe not. So they said that why don't we build something where it's objective and is a programmatic manner where you can identify who is unhappy or who is most likely to leave and not leave it to human judgment. And the CEOs took a lot of time to onboard this, but then I wanted to understand, if this is so good, if this sounds so good to be true, why is it that so many CEOs still haven't adopted the wave of AI? So the interesting bit was very simple, and we call it algorithmic uncertainty, where what happens is, when you have an AI bot or a machine or a tool which makes a mistake, we are very, very harsh on the bot. The first mistake, we lose credibility of the bot and stop trusting the bot. But when a human being makes a mistake, what do you say? Oh, it's a human error. Oh, he or she will learn from it. Let's give it some time. So why do we not have the same approach to bots, where we can allow the bot to learn over a period of time? And that's the fundamental shift we've seen with all of these CEOs. The second thing I'd like to share, which is the fact that it's so simple that we still, in 2017, believe that AI is here to replace us. AI is here to take the human touch away. And still, I'd like to share two examples, two leaders, who I'm sure you'll all relate with. Elon Musk in 2017 says that if human beings do not coexist with AI in 2017, they will be redundant in the future. Steve Jobs, on the other hand, goes deeper. And in the 1990s, when there were riots for computers being launched and computers taking away jobs, he did this very interesting study. He said that what if we compare human beings to other animals and the higher primates and see what is the key difference. And the key difference he noticed was the fact that human beings are tool builders. And when I say human beings are tool builders, what is an example of that? So the comparison he drew out was with this animal called the condor, which is this bird, which is the most efficient animal on this planet. It can travel with the least amount of energy in 1 kilometer. But since human beings are tool builders, somebody thought of giving a human being a bicycle. And this is where, if you give a bicycle to a human, the human has the most efficient energy here. So what the bicycle was to the legs was what was the computer to the mind in the 1990s. And what I'd like to say in 2017 is what AI will be to human beings in the HR. So the question we'd like to ask ourselves and conclude with today is that, are human beings becoming more transactional? Are human beings becoming more robotic? Or is AI becoming more human? Thank you.